As you know, I'm always building skill sets. I really want my life to transform, and I know that building skill sets is the way. In previous videos, specifically platform independence, platform income independence, I talk about the fundamentals. And one of the fundamentals that I haven't mastered is YouTube, storytelling, marketing. Like I'm working on it. And so I joined a coaching program and I joined the coaching program thinking like, do I know anything? And so this is an update. I've been in the coaching program for 30 days and I just wanted to share with you these fundamental, essentially skill sets that I'm learning to try to become better and serve you guys better. So essentially this is, all things YouTube. The audience, learning the audience, what the audience wants is essentially what I'm trying to figure out with the algorithm. So the number one rule of the coaching program is to get, I don't know, maybe he said it was 1% better. This is a Think Media coaching program, but the way I translated that was like get 0.01% better, like every video. And it's been a good for me and difficult for me. It's been good for me to try to get better. And it's been difficult for me because I take really imperfect, dirty action. Like I'm just like, I'll go for it, and we'll land somewhere. So this program is really about mastering getting better. And that is a learning curve for me. In 30 days, I've uploaded 30 long form videos. This includes videos that I have scheduled out. So I don't believe I've published every day in March. But I do plan to publish every day in April for my own growth and development. And I'm making sure that I'm serving you guys at the same time. I did 25 shorts. They weren't that great, but I need to get better. So I have to fail forward, right? I love the community post. If you guys are a part of that on my channel, please, please be involved in those, clicking like and commenting, especially on the surveys. Because you guys get to vote for what videos come next. And that's one of my favorite things is you being there, like the relationship that we're building. In 30 days, I grew 260 subscribers. That is pretty typical for my channel. In September, I grew maybe 1,000. There was a video that kind of took off about Amazon ads. But other than that, it's been pretty slow and steady. So I'm grateful for that. If you're interested in the program, I'm going to share some additional things that I've learned from it, but you can get out your phone or screenshot this, open your phone camera, and it will take you to the sales page. I did the payment plan that's monthly, and it's been really good. So I am on my second month, and I wanted to share a 30-day update. I like to document the journey. It's less, I don't want to say less painful, but you learn more when you document the journey. So I come from a really long history of pioneers that document the journey and that has transformed their life. So that is my dead speaking from the dead. That's my ancestry speaking from the dead, like Jenny document. So if we need separate videos on that, definitely let me know. So here's some of the things that I have really been learning about in the coaching program is thumbnails. If you watch any YouTube videos, you learn that Mr. Beast talks so much about they will spend thousands, hundreds of thousands of hours and time and money on thumbnails because it is the first thing people click on. So I've been working on my thumbnails. I'm testing my thumbnails. You guys see that? You don't click on all my videos. And it's just part of the game to figure out what you guys want. And it's funny that I'm talking to you in this way, like, tell me what you want to make my life easier, right? Like, and but that's the thing with relationships is being able to serve people, over deliver, and grow. I've also been learning about titles that I don't have to do certain things that I was doing before. So I'm really grateful for that. The keywords is really exciting to me because I've just come off a high of Amazon KDP, right? I've come off a high of keywords, focusing on that income stream for a full year. And now I'm focusing on YouTube. And I am focused on all my income streams, but I'm spending different amounts of each day on each income stream. If you think that would be important or it would help you to start building other income streams and see a calendar of my income stream schedule, then comment income stream schedule. ISS. Yes, ISS. Comment ISS. That's much easier. Pardon me. So having a income stream schedule helps me to stay organized, and it makes sure that I'm not neglecting some of my income streams. And it really is about the time that you put into it. And if I were to show you like a revenue report, you would be able to guess like, hey, you haven't been taking that many pictures because your photography earnings are down. Okay. So keywords is really cool because it's like any system where people are searching for things and you can fulfill it by creating a video about that. So I'm learning so much about that. The community in terms of building an audience, that I can't just put out whatever video I want. I'm going to try and do that a little bit because I feel like you guys, I feel like we're friends, but I want to over deliver and I want to serve, and I want you to feel like your life is better because you watched my video. And that's what I really like, is that this past month, more people came into my channel than I see at church on Sunday. And I just feel so much of God's love for you guys, but also myself, of like, how cool is that to build a relationship around the internet about making our lives better? I just think that is so cool. It's really about the consistency, the long game. I have a couple really fun YouTube friends that publish KDP videos, and they have gone viral and they've gotten thousands of followers overnight. And that just hasn't been my experience. And I actually really love the comments by you guys where you're like, how do you not have more followers? But also, like, I love the intimacy because it allows me to spend time to actually respond to you guys when you're like, I turn on an ad, what should I do next? Like, if I had a huge following, it'd be really hard for me to give that type of attention. So I'm really grateful for that. So February, before I joined the coaching program, I've had a couple videos that do okay. You can see I need to work on my shorts more. I don't do a lot of shorts, so I'm going to be working on that. My subscribers was down from the month before, and I hit around $63 of revenue. You're not paid out on Amazon. Sorry, pardon me. You're not paid out on YouTube until you're at a $100 threshold. So I've been paid one time, $122, and this is March. Estimated revenue is going up by a couple dollars every month, which I'm grateful for. My views went up 3,000. My watch time went down, and my subscribers are down from the January. But it's okay because I'm building a legacy income. I'm building a platform where people can come and get to know skill sets that they want to use. If they want to publish books on KDP, if they want to grow a YouTube channel, if they want to create courses, if they want to learn ads. I even think about, like, for those of you that want to generate more income, you could master Amazon ads and then have an Amazon ad agency. There's really a lot of really fun ideas when you start thinking about publishing online, because it's really, to me, the consistency is about documenting the journey when you're building a skill set. So I hope that this fits in with all the other type of videos that I share with you guys about being transparent and honest about the things that I'm learning. But then also too, like, this is the goal, right? The goal is to recognize that something's not optimal and you stop doing it immediately, right? I think we have all experienced that in our life where we thought something was really good and we weren't getting that great of results, and then we changed and it brought peace and flow. And even like taking breaks can make you 1% better. My husband has to remind me of that all the time because I associate a lot of my worth to getting stuff done. And there's nothing wrong with being a high achiever, but I am important even if I didn't have a YouTube channel. You are important even if you don't have a YouTube channel. You are worthy of the goals and dreams that you have, regardless if you get out of bed today. That is just the divine identity of who you are, in my opinion. So if you want that income stream schedule, definitely comment that. And let me know if you have a YouTube channel. And if you do, drop your YouTube channel link in the comments if you're publishing. And let me know what it's about. And if you don't have one, but you're thinking about it, and there's a reason why you don't have it, put the reason, my reason that I don't have a channel, if there's something stopping you. If you don't want one, I see you, I commend you. Like, you don't got to defend yourself to me. If you need some support in getting over, like, getting YouTube up and going, then I want to hear why you haven't, what your reasons are, because sometimes it just talking it out and writing it out can really help you get ahead. So I love you guys. I'm grateful that you're here. Please like and subscribe to be updated. Have a great day. Love you. Peace out.